Hey everyone, John Reed here, author of the 50 Things to See with a Telescope series. In this video, I want to share with you my top 10 personal favorite space astronomy and stargazing books. This is Learn to Stargaze. Now, as a full-time author and professional amateur astronomer, that's a thing, right? Okay. I read a lot of books about space, so I wanted to share with you some of my favorites. Now, this is a very small sample size of the great space books out there, and getting it down to 10 was very hard, and as you'll see, I failed at getting it down to 10. Well, if you have any favorite space books that I didn't include, please feel free to share them in the comments. Now, as a disclaimer, I'm not affiliated with any of these books, and none of the authors have contacted me or asked me to feature their books. That said, because the astronomy community is small, I do know some of these authors personally, or at least for Facebook friends. So in no particular order, here are my favorite books about space, astronomy, and stargazing. Number one, I want to introduce you to my all-time favorite science fiction book, Hyperion. I won't give away any of the plot or what it's about. Basically, it's Canterbury Tales in Space. I used to gift this book to people just to see them call in sick from work to binge read it. If you haven't read it, trust me on this one. And if you do pick it up, be sure to pick up the sequel, Fall of Hyperion, as well. Number two, Night Watch. Until my books came around, this was by far the most popular stargazing book. The reason is simple, it's a veritable encyclopedia of stargazing. Detailed star maps, how-to guides, it's the Swiss Army knife of stargazing books. The book also provides a decent introduction to the science of astronomy and cosmology, with maps such as our place in the galaxy and of the time since the Big Bang. Number three is Binocular Highlights by Gary Cyronic. This is the type of book you can just take outside, lay under the stars, grab a red flashlight, and use without much stress. It actually helped inspire my style of easy-to-use stargazing books. If you live in a place with a clear view of dark skies and own binoculars, this book is for you. Number four is Explore Create by private astronaut Richard Garriott. Richard Garriott is the son of NASA astronaut Owen Garriott. Now, Richard Garriott was one of the very first space tourists. And this book caught me by surprise, and it's not so much that it's about space, but just that it's a fascinating look at how someone sees the world as a story to be told and a game to be played. Now, Richard is a video game designer famous for creating the Ultima series of games, which are loosely based on role-playing games like D&D. This book includes challenges and games that you and a reader can interact with, and I thought that was a totally original way to write an autobiography. Now, number five is a masterpiece. Science fiction book, Seven Eves by Neal Stephenson. I'll read you the very first line. The moon blew up with no warning and with no apparent reason. Not only is the plot completely captivating, the writer's ability to completely change his style from chapter to chapter and from character to character keeps you fully engaged for the length of this book, and you need to be engaged because this book is long. Number six is Astrophotography by Terry Legall. If you're even thinking about taking pictures of space, even if you don't own a telescope or even a camera, get this book first. No matter what type of nighttime photography you might do in the future, Terry covers the basics in this great book. Number seven. Now, this one's not even a book. Well, not yet, anyway. After you've captured your first images of space with a camera, you'll want to check out Trevor Jones's Premium Image Processing Guide on PDF. You can download it from his website, astrobackyard.com. Now, if you're a professional astrophotographer already using PixInsight or some other premium software, this might not be for you. But if you're just getting started and have access to Photoshop, this guide will vastly improve how you process your astrophotos. And number eight. Now, no space book list would be complete without the classic book, Carrying the Fire, An Astronaut's Journey by Michael Collins, Command Module Pilot for Apollo 11. Now, I'm currently reading this book, so I can't give you a conclusive review, but so far, it's one of the most engaging books I've ever read by an astronaut. This book gives you an inside look of what it's like to be one of the Apollo astronauts preparing for and making that historic flight. 8.5. Well, if you've already read Carrying the Fire, a close second most engaging book about the Apollo missions would be Rocket Men by Robert Kersen. Kersen follows the Apollo 8 mission, which was humanity's first voyage beyond low Earth orbit. And if you're looking for another book about the moon, check out For All Humankind by Tanya Harrelson and Danny Bednar. Number nine is Universe in a Nutshell by Stephen Hawking. This book is a very engaging introduction to cosmology for anyone who's interested. I read this book about 5 years before I began my astrophysics degree, and I can tell you it's a much lighter read than his earlier book, A Brief History of Time. I actually bought these books together in a single hardcover, which is pretty cool. Number 10, for anyone who's a fan of Mars, you can guess that my favorite book about Mars is, of course, The Martian. But I'm guessing most of you have already read that or seen the movie. So maybe you tried Red Mars, which I thought was only okay, it was a bit slow. But if you're looking for a Mars book that's totally original and insanely fast-paced, check out Red Rising by Pierce Brown. You won't regret it. I even like this better than The Expanse. For nonfiction books about Mars, check out Packing for Mars by Mary Roach or The Case for Mars by Robert Zublin. Now, of course, I said I couldn't contain this to 10, so this list goes up to 11. So coming in at number 11, Chris Hadfield's book, An Astronaut's Guide to Life on Earth. If you're looking to inspire someone with profound insights about life, gift them this book, even if they're not interested in space. It's been a few years since I've read this book, but Chris's words still resonate with me today, especially this piece of advice: be useful. So I'll just leave you with that. Wherever you are, whoever you're with, be useful. Well, everyone, that's my list of personal favorite space books. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to Learn to Stargaze on YouTube. Follow me at Learn to Stargaze on social media. And remember, the future is looking up.